Thanks to, and hello everyone. As to mentioned just there, my name is Lewis. I'm from Scotland, and for the past 6 months I have been the communication and administration officer here at USTEM 2030, although sadly today is my last day, but I'll discuss that a wee bit later on. I hope everyone's been enjoying the event so far, and all the great speakers we've had on so far. I've been listening to all of them and just hearing how they got into the field, and the work they've been doing is just truly inspiring. You know, it's really fantastic. So sadly, we are nearing the end of the conference. However, we still have some amazing speakers to take the stage, as well as the Youth STEM Matters Awards, neither of which I don't think you want to miss. Just as a wee reminder as well, if you want to share your highlights of the conference so far, please use the hashtag YouthSTEMMattersConf on social media, and you can also feel free to tag at YouthSTEM2030 either on Instagram or Twitter as well. We're really happy to share your experiences with our wider community. So let's welcome our next speaker. I'm pleased to introduce Estefania Olaiz, an inspiring physicist and mathematician. Estefania is a high school senior from Monterrey, Mexico. Currently, she's pursuing an undergraduate degree in physics. She's been nationally recognized for her theory on black holes and will be spending her summer at the International Summer School for Young Physicists at the Perimeter Institute. Additionally, she has written a variety of articles ranging from the Derivation of Lorentz Transformations to Zermelo-Fraenkel my apologies, I'm terrible with pronunciations of words, of set theory. In her free time, she simplifies research in science and mathematics for her newspaper called Simply Academia. She's here with her talk towards geometrically visualize Eigenspaces in pedagogy. Again, I'm so sorry, pronunciation's not my strongest suit, which I'm certain will be a fantastic listen to. Over to you, Estefania.
Hello, my name is Estefania Olaiz, and I'm going to be going over my project titled Towards Geometrically Visualize Eigenspaces in Pedagogy, which I know sounds like an unfair amount of jargon, but I'll explain it in the next few slides. So a brief overview would be the origins, what is it, why is it important, relevance to the SDGs, brief evaluation, limitations, and looking outward, next steps. Starting off with the origins, I began my project after I started working on my article titled An Algebraic and Geometric Approach to Eigenvalues and Eigenvectors. I did attach a few quotes in there just to determine what that actually entails. So in linear algebra, we are introduced to eigenvectors and eigenvalues. Well, eigenvectors are vectors with a direction immutable by a transformation. Eigenvalues are associated with the physical quantity by which the eigenvector is scaled. So I know this says nothing about eigenspaces, which is essentially the main character of my project, but it is necessary for us to understand eigenvectors and eigenvalues, which the quote defined, in order to understand eigenspaces. So we've also determined that it's part of linear algebra. And essentially the note I put in there that says eigenspaces are the eigenvectors associated with a certain eigenvalue defines what an eigenspace is. So eigenvalues don't exist in isolation, they exist in entire spaces. That's essentially what eigenspaces are. And for the average student, most of these concepts can be very difficult to grasp, especially from a geometric perspective. So in the sections of my articles, I use visual representations in addition to algebraic manipulations. So I didn't do it all, but I didn't do both algebra and geometry arbitrarily. Through my research, I came to find just how much geometric struggle was associated with the study of these three concepts, which, by the way, can be characterized by something we call eigen theory. But yeah. So So what is it? Essentially, my project encourages the geometrization of eigenspaces, especially through instrumentalization, more specifically through dynamic geometry software, which is what literature recommends is most beneficial for the study of eigenspaces, which is something I'll cover in the next few slides. Since I mentioned eigenspaces are part of eigentheory, they can be very abstract and they're very difficult to conceptualize, to manipulate flexibly. For example, something we call geometric multiplicity, which defines the dimensions of a linear transformation, can be very difficult to think, especially in the amount of dimensions that you might be managing. That's something we need. We need that ability to flexibly manipulate something both algebraically and geometrically in order to comprehensively understand a subject. And that's essentially the purpose of the instrument I try to develop. This visual defines what that actually means, eigenvectors, eigenspaces. So we can see the linear transformation, and we can see that eigenspaces are defined by the green line, and they just follow the eigenvectors through our coordinates. So why is it important? Well, I believe it's important because it can help improve the state of education, especially because it does this more comprehensively. Since my article talked about eigenvectors and eigenvalues, but excluded eigenspaces, it kind of helped solidify the fact that there are no current tools including eigenspaces, but there are tools including eigenvectors and eigenvalues, which is how I was able to show the visual in my article through the software called GeoGebra. So this can kind of help students, especially those specializing in engineering and mathematics, because linear algebra is very crucial for their education. And my project does have a lot of relevance to one of the UN's SDGs, and it can essentially help increase a sustainable future. So as I mentioned before, it's relevant to SDGs, or specifically SDG number 4, quality education. I attached a quote in there just to define what that actually means. So it would be to ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. So why? Why is it relevant to this particular SDG? Well, just the model that I'm introducing can help with tempered comprehension. So it can help effectively alleviate any sort of difficulties with conceptualization, which are often associated with the eigentheory because of how abstract it is. Just a brief evaluation of my research would be three main bullet points, foundational bodies of knowledge, literature review, instrument design. Foundational bodies of knowledge is by no means a technical term, but it does define the focal concepts that I used to give a direction to my project. So we posed an issue, which is that there is no current visualization for eigenspaces. And this could have been taken anyway, but for example, the theory of instrumental genesis helped define among the literature review, but it did help define how instrumentalization can help solve this issue. Other bodies of knowledge include Dubinsky's APOS theory and Tull's three worlds of mathematical thinking, which I detail in my paper. Literature review it covered most of the work of David Tull. It also covered authors like Ben Chaim, Lappin, Huing, Thomas, and Stewart. And what I came to understand by reading most of their works was that embodied concepts through dynamic geometry software can help with conceptualization of eigentheory. So that's the basis of it all, essentially. And the instrument design defined a few characteristics that the tool itself could have in order to most accurately benefit the students and the teachers in instruction. So an example of this would be that it's web-based. Since most teachers do use their computers to project something up on a screen, maybe, it can be more beneficial that it is web-based, especially because it is not as data-consuming as an app would be. Some limitations, non-exhaustively, include that there are no current testable products to ensure the efficacy of all the claims previously mentioned. So specifically those relating to eigenspaces, and also that there is a lack of study in terms of eigenspaces. So I've seen quite a few studies related to eigenvectors and eigenvalues, but not specifically detailing eigenspaces. And lastly, just looking outward, next steps. I'm currently working on the development of EigenView, which would follow all of the characteristics that I've kind of determined in my paper. It would be the instrument that I've so far developed. And ideally, there would be further research performed on it. So if it had any sort of impact on cognitive comprehension, and just see if it was actually effective. That's pretty much it. And thank you for listening.
Well, that was a truly amazing talk from Estefania. Truly inspiring and interesting. I invite you all to share your appreciation in the chat for that. Again, truly fantastic. So right now we're going to go to a quick break and we will return to the stage at 1520 BST, which is about 7 minutes from now. In the meantime, you can head over to our expo booth area to check out our research showcase and sponsor expo booths. And as a wee reminder, this is your last chance to submit your research conference quest answers before, I suppose, 1520 British BST, to be in with a chance to win some amazing prizes. See you back in a few minutes.